seconds, by the way, to open that motorised tailgate. That will cost you £460. Now this, of course, is the Peugeot 508 SW station wagon. Don't forget, not an estate, unlike the Skoda Superb. And there's another reason for that as well, because the dimensions for the rear hatch aren't that wide or tall, and you would struggle to get a washing machine upright in this car, unlike a Skoda Superb. And although the room does pan out inside, for practicality's sake, it is a problem. Now, with Peugeot marketing this car as a sports tourer, the roofline does come down at both screens, so you've got quite a gently sloping tailgate here. And of course, if you've got boxes, that tailgate won't close. Load cover here is similar to what you'd find on a Skoda Superb, but this one doesn't work as well. This is, of course, the moment where we play Spot the Spare. And, unusually, we will find there is a full-size spare wheel with Continental tyre with a decent jack, which is good. Now, these two latches here will flip down the seat in this one. And that's what you get on a Volkswagen. Let's see how long it takes this 508 to become a station wagon. Quite heavy. Heavier. Now, because the seat bases don't actually fold up, the backs have a slight rise here, so that does impede the heights. And with my trusty tape measure, you will see to the panoramic sunroof that we've got 31 inches. So whilst this area here will be good for a washing machine, this area would be a problem. This 460 pound option motorised tailgate. Safe.
Oh no, my bag's still there. Oh, that's okay.
Now, there are five trim levels in the 508, and the top three have the panoramic sunroof as standard, and that's also on the saloon as well. This is a 2.2 diesel. PSA, of course. You need to put your seatbelt on.
Okay.
Ooh. It's actually giving.
If possible, do a U-turn.
It's actually saying rear left-hand door open. Your door isn't closed properly. Right. Right.
In 200 yards, turn left.
And the diesel engine gives off 200 brake horsepower, and that's saying something. Of course, it is turbocharged, 16 valves. Development of this engine such that the injectors actually have more apertures for a finer diesel fuel spray, which aids combustion.
Turn left.
Now, 1 year ago, I actually tested the Peugeot RCZ, and I criticised the fact that it had orange font, that was quite common on Peugeots before, and they've relegated that to the heating display here, fortunately. And all the other displays you can see, nice clarity, white visual display. And really, you know, it does exude a higher quality than before. Steering wheel, with that chrome piece of trim, or rather plastic, looks exactly like what you'll find on a Skoda, of course, with a Peugeot badge. And you can see there are lots of buttons, a lot of gizmos going on, and this model that we've got here is a GT, which is a top trim level. This will retail at over £30,000. So we have paddle shifts here. We've got a 6-speed Porsche Tiptronic system, and that will allow you to have it in manual. So you've got a push pull gear change if you wish. You've also got sport button there, and you've got an option here for snow. That only comes with this engine size, it's not a manual option. Hear the diesel engine purring away. I don't think it sounds as refined as a Volkswagen Audi one, but the gear changes are seamless and the ride quality is very good. This is a definite step up for Peugeot, and don't forget this relegates the 407 and 607 and fills the niche left. Incidentally, the 607 was one of the highest depreciating cars, and that did not have a station wagon option. And in terms of quality, you know, everything feels very, very solid, very well built. In terms of space, I think that is the issue. Mention about the cargo space at the back, the rear opening isn't as wide as other vehicles like the Skoda Superb. And here I'm very hemmed in. Now you may well be thinking, why on earth would I spend £30,000 buying a Peugeot? Why wouldn't I buy an Audi or Volkswagen, for example? Well, that is a good question. And I think the main benefit of this car is the fact that you get a lot more gizmos, gearbox options, for example. There is a head-up display here, you can see that's only available on this GT model. That shows and reflects the speedometer reading and also sat-nav. This car even has a massage function for the driver, and that is standard. Yeah, compare that to a Volkswagen, Audi, Skoda, you'd have to pay a lot more on the options list.